Hi everyone and welcome to this video on an introduction to Deskpro's admin interface. This video is just to give you a quick walkthrough of how Deskpro's admin works and some of the key areas to be aware of. So, Deskpro's admin. Deskpro's admin area is limited to only certain admins and it gives you access to all of the different admin functionality available. Everything from adding new agents, making changes to your emails, or editing and adding automations across the system as well. When you first come into the admin area, you'll be greeted by this dashboard. The dashboard gives you a few different elements. It gives you quick links to be able to get in touch with the Deskpro support team, as well as read quick guides and information, some quick stats in terms of how many tickets have been created and any changes today, and a quick look at over your agents in the account, including seeing if anybody's in the online status and if they're online or offline for voice and chat if you support those channels as well. It will also show you some quick information about the Deskpro news page, just so you're aware of any changes that we've made as well. In terms of the structure of admin, it directly follows the admin guide, so if you do have any questions or if you're looking for more information, the admin guide will directly reflect the structure of admin as it's laid out here. And the structure of admin is hopefully very intuitive in helping you find the information that you need. For example, everything to do with something like email is under channels, and then you're able to select email, and then you can go into the different settings, whether that's making changes to the templates or making changes to a particular email account within the system as well. Most pages in Deskpro will use a table-like structure like this. From this table-like structure, you've got the ability to use our search functionality and apply any filters. From the right-hand side over here, you can also choose to sort, group, and view elements of the table as well. And you do have access to some mass actions to be able to make mass changes on a little bit quicker in the new interface here as well. You can really simply use the new button to create more elements to these tables, and you're able to click on any element to edit it. We're using a draw functionality throughout the admin a lot, so you can really quickly see all of the information without it loading a new page, but simply keeping everything within a drawer with a simple way to save, discard changes, or delete the element in whole as well. This tends to be used throughout the system. And when you're looking at a page, we might give you some quick links to another element. So from email accounts, you may be very interested in our incoming log, so it will allow you to simply go to this area. And also, we're trying to try and guide you towards any help articles. So if you do need any help with email accounts, there'll be a button that will take you to the guide page on email accounts as well. This structure is not limited to email. This is what we're using across the whole area. You can just click into whichever area you're looking for and then click into the element and it will load up that next page. Hopefully this is really helpful at just giving an overview of the different kind of structures of how we work, and hopefully this will help you navigate the admin interface a little bit more moving forward. There'll be much more videos on creating content and managing admin functionalities in this series as well. Thank you very much.